Hello, my name is Janko Bucic. I'm the chief product owner of the Run Market, and I'd like to introduce you one of our operation platforms called Sub-Focused Run. Today, I'd like to share with you the following agenda. We will first of all discuss a little bit about what is Focused Run, what is our mission. Then we will provide you a kind of overview regarding the functional scope so that you understand what are the use cases in scope. We will then after this talk a little bit about the benefits and also what we plan to do, a kind of roadmap, and also then how you can get it, how you can get the software and how you can implement this. So what is Focused Run? Perhaps we start with this. At the end, Focused Run is a kind of spin-off of our classical platform SAP Solution Manager. SAP Solution Manager is now at version 7.2. And we did a kind of spin-off some years ago to optimize the platform, in particular for high data volumes, with more automation, with higher security, at the end to serve also the purposes of service providers, as well as of the purposes of high-end customers. So in this sense, it's really completely new design product. We took some of the capabilities of Solution Manager, but we enhanced it also dramatically. So we added also new use cases like integration monitoring or end user monitoring to which are simply possible to be integrated because we changed also the technology platform. We are using the full power of HANA as a platform with this. And this allows us now to also store much more data, much higher volumes of data to increase a much better scalability. Sub-Focused Run is really an isolated system. This means it is a separated installation. It is not an add-on on top of Solution Manager, but it's really a separate system. But it can also run side by side with Solution Manager. This means you can, for instance, have your build part in the SAP Solution Manager and the run part in Sub-Focused Run. Sub-Focused Run is really focused on IT operations. So it's not that we add here all the functionality we have in Solution Manager. We will not provide you with build functionality. We will also not provide you with business process operations functionality. It's really an IT tool, and this is optimized for IT tool, but again, on a higher scale with Fava's openness, with Fava security and so on. And it is a licensed product. So you have to acquire a license to get it. Now, what is the functional scope? First of all, with Sub-Focused Run, we support both on-premise products and cloud products, and also this on all the different layers. This means it starts with advanced system management. So the clear plan is to provide you really with all capabilities to keep the lights on for your on-premise systems. And this comes with system monitoring, license management, data collection for our services, IT calendar, and so on. But we also support cloud products. And the first way we support it is user monitoring. This means for on-premise products as well as cloud products, we provide you transparency in the user behavior, in particular from the performance perspective. This comes with a synthetic user monitoring as well as with a real user monitoring. We have the same from the integration perspective. This means for machine-to-machine communication. We call this advanced integration monitoring. Also here we support on-premise product and cloud products. We have also advanced configuration monitoring mainly for on-premise products, making sure that your systems are configured in a way that we are compliant to the latest recommendations of SAP, as well as to your own hardening guides. And this is in particular from security perspective important. Now we have all this monitoring, we collect all this data. What we now intend to do with the data is a sufficient event and alert management. This means you can specify for all the use cases we have here in scope alerts and be notified if one of these problems is happened, if a problem is detected, to react appropriately on it. We have also advanced root cause analysis, in particular for systems. We call this also system analysis, also trace analysis is part of this, simply making sure that we can dive deeper in the root cause analysis. For instance, we can get 10-second threat samples of an HANA box to really do a deep dive root cause analysis. And then on top of this, we have advanced analytics and intelligence. This means we are taking data out of all these different baskets and visualize it in a way how customers like to see it. So this means dashboards, which are using different data sources, can be defined customer specifically, and the data can be presented as the customer likes it. And we add also intelligence capabilities. This means we predict also based on the data certain things to at the end avoid, for instance, production down situation. We call this system anomaly analysis, if you heard this term. Now in deeper detail, we have the advanced system management. Again, it is intended to provide management of very huge landscapes. Actually, we are using this also SAP internally, and I think we have in the meantime accessed to our internal focused run system around 30,000 systems. So it's really highly scalable. You can attach a lot of managed systems to one focused run instance. We provide you also out of the box with the appropriate content. This means system monitoring is available simply by applying the templates we are delivering as part of the system. You just apply it to your systems and then it is working. Also, the assignment of system is optimized. So we took care that you can do this on a high volume with a very low effort. System monitoring is intended for auto-discovered, completely modeled systems. However, we have also unmodeled systems like third-party systems, cloud services, and so on. So for this, we have the open component monitoring. So the open component monitoring provides you with a kind of baseline monitoring, low barrier, with a low barrier entry point to at the end provide monitoring at a certain level, for instance, availability checks, URL monitoring, and so on. And we have also job monitoring as part of the system management. This means you can also monitor basis jobs as well as application jobs and make sure that this is working correctly. We have also the IT calendar work mode management service availability management as a kind of management tools to make sure that you can work appropriately with your landscape, that you can, for instance, plan downtimes and then the monitoring reacts appropriately, or that you can, for instance, also define some SLAs. And then based on these SLAs, you can also measure based on the real performance and the planned downtimes whether your SLA is still fulfilled or not. We also added system health checks. This means you can also start on regular basis certain checks, for instance, once a week. You can define these checks by yourself, and then you get a report which gives you a kind of snapshot regarding the healthiness of your current considered system. We have also license and maintenance certificate management. This means we exchange with the support backbone the maintenance information and we implement the maintenance certificate in the managed systems, as well as we are collecting data for the maintenance planner, which is running also in the SAP support backbone, which calculates you at the end also the necessary upgrades and patches you need to keep your systems up to date. Also, what we provide you is the data collection for the Early Watch Alert service. This means we fill a kind of download container, send it to the SAP support backbone, and then the actual processing of the session is executed in the support backbone, as well as we collect this information also for the remote services like Early Watch, like Going Live Check or OSDB Migration Service. Also here the same logic applies. This means we collect the information, we put it in a download container, upload it to the support backbone, and then the services are processed where. Okay, let me show you the first demo. Now I like to show you a short demo regarding the health monitoring in FocusRAN. We select a certain scope. And now we see all the different categories which are provided by health monitoring. I like to show you here now something what we developed relatively newly, which is called monitoring for Kubernetes. So more and more infrastructures are moving into Kubernetes direction. Appropriately, we invested also here. So this means if you have a Kubernetes cluster, then we can also monitor it with open component monitoring. You can also add tags, and then you can also group the visualization of the different metrics based on this text. So here we put, for instance, namespaces in scope, which is a category of Kubernetes. And you can also drill down in the graphical representation of the data. So you see here also in detail, for instance, how certain metrics were behaving over time for a bunch of namespaces which are here considered. You can also change the resolution of the data, as you see here. So all of this is directly available for you without a big, let's say, configuration effort. We have also now added functionality for CPI, for cloud monitoring, cloud platform integration. So here we have also implemented a kind of health check. And then you see here also what types of health checks we are providing you. You see we have some certificate checks, we have some queue capacity checks or other things. And also here you can apply this grouping as I just described here in this case, for instance, sorted by ratings. And also here we provide you inline the visualization of the metrics. You can also switch to another time frame as you see here and so on. So this is also directly possible at your fingertips. So very convenient to be used by you. So this was the demo regarding the open component monitoring. Let's now switch to the user monitoring. In the user monitoring, at the end, it comes in two flavors. We have in real user monitoring as well as in synthetic user monitoring. At the end, the clear target is bring transparency in the experience of the users. And again, both use cases are highly relevant. Real user monitoring is in particular relevant to understand the behavior and the performance of the different end users which are in your systems. What is the special thing here in our capability is that we measure also the front end time without having an agent or something at the front end. So we do this by our frameworks for SAP UI 5 and for SAP GUI to really measure what is going on the front end, the performance which is spent where. And then we also measure in every involved server component also the performance. Synthetic user monitoring, as the name says, is based on simulated requests. This means we record a certain scenario. We, at the end, upload this scenario to a certain robot. And this robot is then replaying this scenario on a regular basis. To make this a little bit more transparent, I like to show you also a short demo. This is again the launchpad of SAP Focus Run, and here we start now the synthetic user monitoring. We have an appropriate tile, as you see. So this is the entry screen for the synthetic user monitoring. Here we can now select a certain scope, in this case a cloud application. And once this is selected, we can now see here also how it is behaving. We see also the performance on different locations. You see here also whether certain errors are happened, so content problems are measured. And we see some of the executions are fine, others not. We see here also directly the performance which is used. Now we can drill down in the different robots and also in the different clicks which are executed. If you now to analyze the behavior from one location, we can also look in this. Then we see here all the executions from this particular locations. We see all the steps which are executed. And now what is completely new is that we can now also track the single clicks from end user perspective. This means we are simulating really the end user clicks instead of the HTTP traffic. And this gives us now the chance also to see the screenshots to really understand what was executed by the end user. So also here we did a lot of enhancements. And also we can do the performance measurement now at single click level, not an HTTP request level. You see here for every single click and every activity which is done in the end user UI, how was the performance for this particular click. In addition, we can then see in the table below here the performance which is spent or the time which is spent to load a certain resource. So we can also now here display the full name of the resource, which is a kind of static resource which is loaded from the server. And you can then also directly see, let's say, how much, what is the data volume, as well as what is the performance. As said, synthetic user monitoring, the big change is that we really simulate now the end user behavior and not only the HTTP traffic. Let's now go to the integration monitoring. Integration monitoring is the approach to really make sure that integration is working correctly. This means that data can be exchanged between cloud services and on-premise systems in a reliable way. For this, we collect from all the different involved components, the integration artifacts. as well as we construct out-of-office integration artifacts message flows. We do this for orchestrated interfaces as well as for peer-to-peer interfaces. We also just added functionality for central finance, which is very intense of exchanging data. For this, we developed something what we call data flow verification. All of this is presented in dashboards. You can always drill in the data and really make visible how the data flow was and see in detail where we at, in particular, critical situations. If you don't have the complete message flows, we have also exceptions. So this means you can also collect per component exceptions and also drill down in the exceptions. We have also added something what we call a message and document search. This means you, if you have a kind of business attribute like a purchase order or like a sales order, you can type this in. And then you see all messages which are associated to this particular business object. As said, we have also end-to-end monitoring. We can orchestrate and based on the different message artifacts, end-to-end message flows. We are using for this the passport as correlation mechanism, as well as we have an embedded alert management. Now I introduce to you to all these monitoring use cases. Very likely nobody like to sit always in front of such an event and alert management and appropriately like to sit in front of a monitoring. Appropriately, we provide you also with an event and alert management. This means we can take this monitoring data and can calculate out of it alerts based on thresholds, which are can be specified use case specific. Alert management comes with an intuitive alert inbox. Via dashboards, the complete alerts are visualized. You can then drill in a certain topic. We have also provided you capabilities like alert search and alert reporting. So historic alerts can be, for instance, visualized in the alert reporting. We also just recently enabled alert clustering. This means if you have alerts which are somehow associated to each other because we are belonging to the same system, or we are belonging to an instance, to instances which are belonging to the same system and so on. We calculate out of this alert clusters, which at the end reduces the overall volume of alerts you have to handle. We also added alert response procedures, meaning reactions to alerts. For instance, for non-availabilities, we provide you also with a collection mechanism so that you can analyze this in deeper detail. We have integration in both directions. You can send alerts to our alert management, for instance, from infrastructure tools, or you can also export our alerts to other tools like ServiceNow or the service desk of SAP Solution Manager. Also for this, we have an extension point simply to make sure that we can also export these alerts. And again, we have here also a fuzzy search. You can also search with a combination and with parts of alert names, of managed objects, and so on to really work efficiently with these alerts. Then I like to introduce to you the advanced configuration monitoring. At the end, what we are doing here is we are collecting snapshots of configuration and we store it in our configuration change database. And then you can define policies. This is a kind of has to be status is described in the policies. And when we compare more or less this to be situation with the as is situation, and we see then exactly where are the derivations and where you have to react appropriately. SAP delivers with policies out of the box. We have regular patch days and everything what need to be checked is then also exposed by SAP. So you can take our recommendations, you can build based on this your own hardening guides from security perspective, and you can use this as the appropriate policies. We did a lot of effort to make also this policy maintenance as efficient as possible for you. We provide you with these policies via a GitHub access, so simply also to give you a low barrier entry point for this. You can also work with this configuration by browsing and searching it. Also on a high volume, so if you have a lot of configuration items and you know, for instance, only a part of the parameter name, then you can also work with this. We have then also the capability to analyze software and parameter changes. So this means if you have a change, then this is discovered and you can appropriately react to this. We deliver you everything out of the box. This means the content comes with the tool. It's not that we deliver it isolated. We try to make sure that the content is directly available for you and you have not to do a lengthy research what you like to check. And all of this is also integrated with alerting and with notification management. This means once, for instance, you have a problem in one of your policies and this is discovered, then you can also generate an alert out of it. And this is then also visible in the alert inbox. And you can also integrate customer-specific data providers and content. This means if you like to enhance the infrastructure with your own content, this is also possible. And then we have the root cause analysis. And root cause analysis is in particular necessary to enable yourself to analyze a problem in deep detail. System monitoring helps you to discover an issue. For instance, you see that your HANA box has a certain issue. And now the next question is how we can resolve it. And for this, we developed a dedicated capability, what we call system analysis. And system analysis is working in a way that you can, at the end, collect on a high frequency snapshots of your systems. And this is developed for HANA as well as for ABAP systems. So you can get 10-second snapshots. And then you see in deep detail, for instance, for HANA, what is actually currently running in the different HANA threads. Or you can see for ABAP what is currently running in the different ABAP work processes. And yet you can drill down in this information and you can discover exactly the critical SQL statement or the critical ABAP program, which causes a certain hanging situation. Yeah? So it's a very, very powerful tool. It's developed together with our IT. Our IT always has to analyze such critical situations to and also play this back to our development units. And this is exactly what we are doing here. System analysis comes with standard content, is always for HANA, for ABAP, for J2E, for BOBJ, for Tomcat, and so on. So all the metrics are delivered out of the box. We have not do something specifically. And what we also just added recently here is the so-called open KPI store. This means you can now also bring in your own metrics in the system analysis. So for instance, if you have an APM tool, you can then also pump data from this APM tool to FocusedRun. In addition, we have trace analysis. Trace analysis, similar approach as in real user monitoring. You can use end user requests end to end, including switching on dynamically traces, as well as we have a system file system browser, which gives you access to remote file systems to download, for instance, certain files and to analyze these file systems in deeper detail. Last but not least, we have advanced analytics and intelligence. And here in particular, we have different flavors of analytics. We have embedded analytics built in the different use cases, but we have also cross use case analytics. These are dashboards which collect data from different use cases and visualize it together in one dashboard. And then we have also cross scenario analytics. And this is at the end exposing the data to an external analytics tool like SAP Analytics Cloud. So with this three-tier analytics capabilities, we think we should satisfy all wishes of customers. Embedded analytics is configurable. Cross use case analytics, you can even define the different data sources. And you can also define how the different things are visualized. And when cross scenario analytics gives you the opportunity to define your dashboards completely by yourself. We have also prediction capabilities. And here in particular, I like to mention the system anomaly prediction. We like to make sure that we can discover already outage info situations before they are happen. And to do this, we are using machine learning capabilities. We analyzed outages in our environments and try to make sure that we have all the data available to provide this analysis in deep detail. I also like to do here a short demo. Again, we start with the launchpad of SubFocusedRun. And here I like to show you an example out of the OCC dashboards. It starts with an empty screen. So you can define here now your own views. And you see we did this here in this example. Important is that we have here views from different use cases. You see here, for instance, a view from the real user monitoring. With this map, you can now also say I have a certain user behavior per location. You can also have, for instance, views from the synthetic user monitoring, or you can also views from the alert management. We can also then directly link in the alert inbox. We have then also, again, from the synthetic user monitoring certain things. We can also link certain views with each other, as you see here. And with this one, we can also, you see here, it's changing in the visualization. I can drill down in this, so we can also add more rich functionality. You see below, we have also open component monitoring data here in, and as well as we can also have configuration and security analytics data in, drill down in the different configuration items. And then also here, we have a mixture of synthetic user monitoring and real user monitoring. Here in the success factor scenario, we can also drill in this. So this was the demo for Operation Control Center dashboards. Let's now switch to the next section of the presentation, the benefits and the roadmap. So perhaps I elaborate a little bit on the direct benefits you get. First of all, what we did is we reduced dramatically the technical footprint of the stack. So we are using actually from the architecture perspective for sub-focused run, the HANA is the persistency layer, the ABAP server is the server layer, and SAP UI5 is the UI layer. So this is standard technology, which is used also for S4HANA on-premise. This means we follow here at the end, always the technology is exposed by S4HANA. Also on the long term, we are very future-proof with this because this is a very well-distributed product, also with a huge and great future in front of it. So in this sense, we are following this. And by doing so, we simplified the architecture. So we also removed certain things like the J2E stack or business warehouse, the CRM we removed, the DBA cockpit we removed, as well as the extraction framework. So we analyzed really where did we have problems in past in terms of maintainability, in terms of TCO, and everything what is not absolutely necessary, we removed out of the stack. Yeah. At the end, with the clear target, reduce the TCO. We also streamlined the communication. So we had before a mixture of different communication paradigms. In the meantime, we have only push-based communication. This means configuration is pushed from focused run to the managed systems, and vice versa, matrix events and configuration items are pushed from the agent to the focused run. And all of this runs via HTTP. So HTTP is the only communication protocol, and this makes sure that you have also the setup effort is dramatically reduced, because if you like to have a secure configuration, we like to make sure that you have not to configure all these different protocols. Scalability, performance, data throughput, you see here the numbers. So it's really dramatically improved. Again, it's proven that we can handle with one system, 30,000 systems. With the usual manager, perhaps several hundreds. So in this sense, this is really a improvement by factors. Performance is increased. This means in particular, the applications react much faster because we have to be prepared to run with such a high volume of systems. And also important, the data throughput is increased. The way how we process the metrics once they are received by the stacks is completely different. So we have very less manipulations. We write it directly to the HANA layer. And also very important, the data footprint is decreased. This means the space you need at the end at the persistency layer due to the HANA compression is dramatically reduced by factor 20, as you see here. Security, everything is built in. This means security by default. At the end, we are using only HTTP as the remaining protocol between agents and the focused run system. You can completely make this secure with HTTPS utilization, but also the communication to the managed system from agent to the managed system is completely secured. And you can also run it in a way that you run different customers in one focused run system. This is in particular important for the service provider scenario. And here we separate the different customers from each other by so-called customer network segments. So this means in the landscape management database, we have dedicated spaces which are used to make sure that the data is really completely and in a safe way let's say, isolated from each other. We have much lower TCO from agent perspective because the simple diagnostic agent, which is similar to the diagnostic agent, but it is running now as a plug-in in the host agent. So it is embedded. It's not an isolated running agent in this sense. And we at the end, with this one, we have also the complete life cycle of the diagnostic agent can be controlled remotely. This means you can start the agent, the diagnostic agent, you can stop it remotely, you can update it, you can install it, and so on. All of this is done completely automatically possible via the host agent. We have also now added something what we call a preparation tool. And this at the end implements all the preparation steps at the managed systems. So also here we try to automate this. This was the remaining part to make sure that you have also here as less effort as possible to assigning managed systems. And then also important, if you have a change in your landscape, then automatically the reconfiguration has happened. This means your landscape is automatically then again reconfigured and works automatically out of the box without any manual manipulation in addition. So let me talk now about the sub-focused run roadmap. First of all, we proceed with our release cycle. We just delivered in May Focus Run 2.0 Feature Pack 3. And we plan to deliver now in fall Focus Run 3.0 Support Package 0. And then every half a year, we will provide a new delivery. So this is more or less the clear path forward. We have plenty of new innovations already in the May release in Feature Pack 3 on different angles. And now in the Focus Run 3.0 Support Package 0, we will provide you also with a lot of new functionality. Perhaps to highlight some things, we will provide you with a synthetic user monitoring, Selenium-based, that you simulate really single user clicks and make sure that at the end, we have also the appropriate front-end measurement in place so that we can really follow every single click. This is one thing we provide. We will establish a health monitoring. So the former open component monitoring will be in a certain sense revamped in a health monitoring, serving as systems as well as cloud services. We will also introduce a new category called advanced application management. And here we will bundle all capabilities which covers both cloud services as well as systems. We will also provide you with support for agentless push-based data transfer. Here the background is that more and more our cloud services send data via push to the managing infrastructure. And we will also appropriately enable this in Focused Run so that you can receive data also from our cloud products. As well as we will finalize our UI unification project. This was also done based on customer feedback. So customers told us, we see here and there a different user behavior. Can you perhaps invest in a unification? And we did this. And this will be now finished with FRAN 3.0 Support Package 0. And then on the long run, we will invest in correlation. First step was alert correlation in system for system monitoring alerts. We see here much more potential to correlate also cross use cases potentially to get at the end less alerts and more, let's say, meaningful alerts. Openness is another thing we have to consider. We like to make sure that we can also pump in data, that we also get at the end external data sources integrated in Focused Run. And then machine learning, I told already this example with system anomaly analysis. Here we're also looking for new use cases. We like to make sure that you at the end also get everything in place what you need. And in this way, we will proceed, as you see, with prediction, with automation, and for sure, we add content more and more. Good, now how can you get it? At the end, very straightforward. If you are interested in sub-focused run, we would conduct with you a so-called focused run positioning workshop. This is a four-hour workshop, can be delivered remotely, or if Corona is gone, also on-site. And with this one, we can give you at the end really a clear guidance regarding different use cases. We also discuss with you What is the hardware sizing? What kind of license you need? What is the recommended consulting package? At the end, everything what you need to start a focused run implementation project. And then our sales account, our account manager will get in touch with you and will provide you with a license. And then we start typically the implementation project with the project setup and architecture workshop, simply to make sure that you have a good start, a kind of jump start. In this workshop, we also go with you in deep detail in the architecture of Focused Run, as well as we check with you how Focused Run fits perfectly in your landscape. We discuss topics like certificate management, landscape management. Shall we use a central SLD? Shall we direct the SLD data providers directly to Focused Run, and so on. So all this type of technical questions we discuss in deep detail, as well as we assign the first systems to your Focused Run system, that you get also a clear feeling how this is working. Okay. What else? We have different other sessions we like to provide to you. You see here, we have session IIS 112, where we also discuss a little bit operation solution for hybrid landscapes. And also we have here some additional information on our public sites. We have on one hand side a kind of homepage, which can be found in the support portal, as well as we have an expert portal. In the expert portal, we in particular expose to you information coming from more the technical side. So what is the latest content? We give you guidance regarding configuration and so on. At the end, all information to use the tool efficiently. We shall also advertise a little bit the learning experience from the SubTechEd in 2020. You see a lot of information which could be used. You see that we have different entry points to work with this, different ways how you can get in touch with us. Please use all of these capabilities to make more out of the event and to understand better how we providing you the information. Saying this, I like to close my session. I like to thank you for your attention. And in case of further questions, please get in touch with me directly via the email address, which is shown here. Or you can also get in touch with my colleague, Stefan Lahr. And also his email address is directly mentioned here. Thank you very much for your time, and I wish you a wonderful day. Thank you.